We'll see, we'll see. Oh my God. That is the coolest thing I've seen.
Thank you. Okay, hope you enjoyed that one. That was the Walls of Jerusalem in Tasmania. I chose to do the circuit track, which was 37.7 kilometers and just under 1500 meters of elevation gain. If I had my time again, I probably wouldn't do the circuit section. The vast majority of people just do an out and back trail, which I can definitely understand now that I've done the circuit. I mean, it was very, very overgrown in some sections, and in my opinion was actually quite underwhelming in terms of looking at the surrounding scenery. And there was just a lot of plains, a lot of dense bushwalking, and something I can't really recommend, especially when you've got the walls literally only a few kilometers on the other side. So yeah, if I was to do it again, I would strongly advise just doing the out and back track. Overall though, I was super impressed with this trail. I think in terms of effort versus reward, this one ranks very, very highly. Obviously, you've got that reasonably steep incline pretty much as soon as you get out of the car, which can be a little bit daunting knowing that you've got that straight up. But once you get over that incline, it is relatively easy going and very, very scenic as well. So yeah, once you put in the effort and the hard yards at the start, you will be rewarded for the rest of the hike. You do have a few peaks after that to clamber up on the top of. Don't get me wrong, they will get your heart pumping, but in my opinion, the hardest section of this trail is the very first couple of kilometers. So if you can do that, then you can do the rest of the hike, and I can tell you, you'll really enjoy this one. There were two main campsites that everyone seems to camp at. The first one that you encounter is called Wild Dog. I chose to walk pretty much straight through this, hardly even looked at it, but I could see that they were wooden platforms. It was really, really chockers when I was going through there, so I didn't even consider it. Plus, it was only about 9 or 10 in the morning, and I still had a lot of hiking and ground to cover, so I just decided to power on through. I do know that there is a long drop there, so if you're busting to go, that is a decent opportunity to do so. So I powered on to Dixon's campsite, which is the second campsite, and it was also rather popular, but in my opinion, much, much better. I preferred this one because of the nice greenery and the landscape that was around. There was plenty of space for heaps and heaps of people to set up a tent. Even the amount of people there, if I had to guess, there would have been about maybe 15 tents. So even then, there was still ample space to set up another 15 or 20 tents if needed be. There's also a nice little stream that goes by where you can collect your fresh water. That's also where I saw the platypus. Still pinching myself about that one. So yeah, super, super stoked with that. So on the actual Tasparks website, it's recommended to do this in 3 days, but I would probably advise to do this in 2 days if you have any sort of fitness level. In my opinion, 3 days, you would be going very, very slowly, and I think you'd only be hiking maybe 4-5 hours tops, and you'd be taking your sweet time as well if you were to do that. So personally, I would recommend doing it in 2 days, but again, if you like to go slowly and just enjoy it, 3 days is definitely on the cards as well. I can definitely see this one being a family orientated hike as well. There was actually a couple of kids out and about. This is a perfectly length hike for families, and I can really see this one being a popular hit on like long weekends or in the school holidays or something like that. So this was actually one of two hikes that I did in Tassie for this trip. I flew into Hobart on the 20th of February. By the time I got my car sorted and all my gear loaded, it was around 6 p.m. and I had a 4-hour drive ahead of me to the trailhead. Ended up getting there about 10 p.m. and that is where I just decided to sleep in the car. But I had an absolute shocking one because it was so freezing and the moon was shining like it was day. So that forced me to get up pretty early the next morning. But nevertheless, fast forward a day and a half, I was back at the vehicle around 1 p.m. and headed straight to Freycinet National Park. which if you follow me on Instagram, you would have been well aware. I did post a couple of photos and videos up there, so please feel free to go check them out if you haven't seen it already. But in my opinion, this was one of my favorite hikes and probably one of the best hikes I've done. So that will be hopefully up on the channel in the next week or two. And until then, I will see you in that next video. Thank you so much for watching.